I love Abomination as much as the next guy. And I'm happy to see Emil Blonsky is once again walking the streets of the MCU. But how exactly did he escape? We know that after the Duel of Harlem, when he got choked out by Bruce Banner, he was taken into custody and put into cryostasis in a maximum security prison known as the Vault, somewhere in Barrow, Alaska. We heard S.H.I.E.L.D. agents, specifically Coulson, talk about that prison whenever he would playfully threaten younger agents with a miserable new assignment if they mess up at work. So we know the Vault is no laughing matter. So how exactly did the Abomination escape? Well, since we know that the Dark Avengers are around the corner and that Valentina Allegra DeFontaine has been trying to round up superpowered individuals, then it'd be tempting to guess that she's behind his escape. After all, she's already got Yelena Belova under control. If you remember the events of the Black Widow movie, then you'll recall that Belova is Natasha Romanoff's spy sister when they were both assigned to the same undercover family in America. Belova received the same Black Widow training as Romanoff, and with the latter's death in Avengers Endgame, it seems like Belova could easily fill in Natasha's shoes. But there's a twist. Allegra DeFontaine has convinced Belova that Hawkeye murdered Natasha on Vormir. So, the Widow won't just easily join up with the Avengers. She's decided to seek vengeance against Hawkeye, and in that way is aligned with the yet-to-be-named supervillain team Fontaine has been assembling. Fontaine also snagged John Walker after the United States government fired him as Captain America. Immediately after, thinking that he had ruined his entire life, John Walker was sitting in the halls of a building in the Capitol, wondering how he could screw his life up so badly. Then, Fontaine arrived. She offered him a chance to be a new type of a Captain America and gave birth to the US agent. Again, the MCU has yet to describe what type of team Fontaine is assembling. Is it the Masters of Evil, the Thunderbolts, or Dark Avengers? We can't be sure. Especially since Kevin Feige and the MCU like to swap characters in and out of various storylines and team titles. They turned the Planet Hulk storyline into Thor Ragnarok, which was probably the craziest Frankenstein sort of story that they could have done yet. I mean, the movie was awesome, don't get me wrong, but it was nothing like the events of the comics. They not only stole the full storyline from Hulk, but they also took a lot of the characters from the Gore and the God Butcher and pasted them over Hela. Specifically that famous line, "What are you the god of again?" Suffice to say, the MCU mixes it up a lot. So we can't really say what this team will be, but it really seems like Abomination is going to be a part of it. They've already got an evil version of Black Widow and an evil version of Captain America. Who else is on the list? Thor, Hawkeye, Iron Man, and Hulk? Well, they don't really need to look much farther than the Abomination for their evil version of the Hulk. So when we ask the question, how did Abomination get out of the vault, we might be able to point at Fontaine and simply say, she did it. But I think there's a simpler answer here. I think Thanos released Abomination. I'm guessing that right after the snap, the vault lost at least half of its staff, and either immediately or in the weeks that followed, the systems that were in place to make sure the Abomination's cryostasis chamber stayed at the correct temperature eventually malfunctioned, and Emil Blonsky was woken from his slumber. Since the world was in such disarray, Abomination could likely survive in the shadows and the underworld. As long as he didn't have another city-breaking fight with a Hulk-level superhero, then he could live his life as a free man. This might actually have a big shot at being true, since we saw the Abomination fighting in an underground tournament in Shang-Chi. But there might be an even more poetic reason for Abomination's release. What if Hulk did it? After the Avengers' Great Time Heist, they reassembled the Infinity Stones, and Hulk snapped 50% of the universe back into existence. What if the Abomination was one of the victims of the original snap, and Hulk brought him back? It should make sense that the Abomination would be able to walk free immediately after returning back to existence. After all, if he had been gone for 5 years, the cryostasis chamber in the vault wouldn't need to be powered. Abomination would basically wake up and punch through the prison walls. Now, the important question that needs to be asked is, when exactly does Shang-Chi take place? Is it before or after Hulk brought back half of the universe? If it's before, then that means Abomination was never snapped away by Thanos, and that he either busted out of the vault because the remaining staff didn't make sure the temperatures in his chamber were cold enough, or a completely different reason that I didn't cover. But if Shang-Chi takes place after the blip, then the theory that Hulk freed him might be right.